To understand what makes Silent Hill really scary, we need only to view this interview with Takayoshi Sato in the making of Silent Hill 2.
Psychological horror has to shake human's heart, deeply. You know, shaking people's heart deeply means uncover people's core emotion and their core motivation for life. Everybody is thinking and concerning about sex and death every day. And if we want to scare or shake or touch the users or spectators, then we have to think about sex and death deeply.
During Silent Hill 2, James would catch the Pyramid Head doing unsightly things to various creatures. If you really watch, it's not doing anything. But deep down, you know it's wrong because it so closely resembles some sort of sex crime. It's something that allows your mind to roam and fill in the blanks. In Silent Hill 3, there would be many ideas of sexual themes hinted at, with the slurper being dressed in S&M garb and nurses being treated in ways we inherently know are wrong. But ever since, all the developers have taken these subtle themes and pushed them over the top so far as to make them blatant. In Origins, we are treated to slutty Lisa.
Poor slutty Lisa.
And a nice scene of the butcher mutilating a nurse's privates. In Homecoming, all the monsters are just naked. Naked Sharkman, naked scissor feet, naked caterpillar thing with a head up its butt, naked Barbie doll, naked pregnant robot Spider-Woman sucking on its own vaginal fluid through a hose, and also...
Face Gina!
May it be an evening star.
The other theme, death, was left ambiguous in previous games as well.
Images of death were quite obvious, and yet the figures may or may not be even people. When Heather sees the body in the Borley Haunted Mansion, she questions whether or not it's real. These are images that leave a definite impression of death without actually showing it. And when you are shown a real dead person, the face is always obscured. In Origins, this theme is almost entirely absent. The only scene that exhibits the theme of death is when Travis sees his father hanging from a noose. No ambiguity whatsoever.
Your mother.
Homecoming just shoves blood and gore all up in your mouth and nose. Watch your mother get torn in half. Watch your father get torn in half. Look at this guy who's been cut in half. Hey, look at these people who were tortured and killed. All this topped off by the players engaging in the act of killing real people over and over. Your mind is not allowed to wander, and instead you are just shown the horrible stuff you are meant to imagine.
It's just like an American horror movie.
You're right! An American horror movie about Silent Hill!
We can almost guarantee the people over at Climax were watching the Making of Silent Hill 2 video.
Sex is death. It's a leap into the void. The great loss of self. The tiger in space. A plea for annihilation. To deny sex is to deny death itself.
Guys, you can't just put it in there and hope it works. You can't just have a guy say it. You have to use it in the correct way. Silent Hill 1 through 4 have players questioning these themes because the images, sounds, activities, all that stuff, displaying such, are obscured and distorted, and therefore have us considering them on a much deeper level than if we are just shown explicit examples.
Shazam is devoid of any disturbing or distorted images of sex or death, instead trading this for disturbing text messages and voicemails about them. These, as in past failures, are blatant to the extent of a picture and phone message about a child who died during autoerotic asphyxiation.
Oh yeah.
There is a huge difference between disturbing and disgusting. This is why the creepy weirdness of a lunatic's obsession is more effective than a text message that says, "My teacher raped me and then choked to death on a used condom."